Hey guys, Taki here. This is going to be a smaller video, but we're going to cover a pretty cool change to an application that I talked about in my last video. This is an update to the Box 86 and Box 64 emulator that allows us to use the Steam Deck UI on ARM processors. This is something that wasn't possible while I was making that last video, but an update came out today and it allows us to do what you can see on screen right now. There are a couple of things that we need to talk about before I can show off the performance of this system. The first one is the fact that this needs a lot of RAM to be able to be used. On the device that I'm using right now, I have 8 GB of RAM, but the board that I was using in my last video had 16 GB, and I am noticing that the 16 GB variant was operating a little faster than this is. This demo is running off of an RK3588 processor, but this is possible on a lot of ARM processors. This is just the easiest thing that I have available to me since I was already working on this for my last video. The great thing about everything that you're going to see in this video is the fact that we're not that far off from having handhelds with this processor in them, which means a lot of what you're seeing right now will be a reality in the not too distant future. We're going to switch over to an HDMI capture of this system in just a moment, but I want to explain the system that I have set up here. The controller that I have here is not actually connected to the thing that's displaying this picture. This is actually connected to an SBC that's off camera. This is the NanoPi R6S. It has an RK3588S processor with 8 GB of RAM, and I have it set up with a VNC server to this Android phone. This is just the best way that I have right now to conceptualize what this will be like when this becomes a reality for a lot more devices. I intended to film this entire video with this janky setup because like everything does work. It's running off of an ARM processor, it's displaying on an ARM processor, but the video signal isn't that good. Like even under a Wi-Fi 6 connection, it still has a lot of latency, and this setup even natively has a lot of jank to it, but I don't want to make it seem worse than it is because this is actually a really cool update that we got. So we're going to switch over to the HDMI capture now. So here's our system. I've just done a few things from a stock Armbian image for the R6S. The first thing that we need to do is lock our system to max so we can get the best performance possible. Even though this doesn't have a fan, it doesn't get that hot while gaming because the heatsink for this is pretty huge. I have a script on my desktop for this to make things easier. Now you can see that all of my clocks are locked to the maximum frequencies that are supported on this board, and the governors are also set to performance. The next thing that we need to do is make sure that our GPU drivers are working correctly, and I've started to use WoW for this because it's a good system benchmark and a configuration benchmark. If you can get this game to boot up with acceleration, nothing else should give you any issues. As long as this isn't running at like 10 FPS, everything is working. I had to get some manual stuff to get this to work that I didn't have to do on my other boards, but I hope that will be addressed so it's easier for other people with this processor to get this going. After that, we just need to launch Steam, and I have a launcher for that. It just types the word Steam into a terminal window. This will boot Steam into the small mode. Before this latest update, this was the only UI that you could use. Even on the build that I was using in my last video, big picture mode was broken. Now, everything is fixed, including the store. What we are now going to do is try out big picture mode. So we're just going to click on the option to launch it. It's a little wonky when it first loads up, but it still works. Here we are with the UI fully loaded. I'm going to switch over to another account because this one doesn't have access to these games and I need them to be able to test the system further. Let's quickly go over some of the settings. Under the performance section, I have the FPS counter set to the top left, but I'm not sure if that works. You may have already noticed, but we have some slight lag as we open up these menus. I'm not sure if this is something that can easily be fixed in the future or not. Let's go into settings and see what we've got. I haven't joined the beta channel on this, so nothing is selected right now. I didn't want to mess with it on the off chance that it implemented something that would break this system again. Under the About section, it has all of the information about this SBC, and the hardware is listed as being a Pentium 4 processor with a lot of physical cores. It has the correct RAM amount listed, and it shows that we have a PanFrost driver. In Display, I have used the Disable GPU Blocklist feature to see if it would help improve the speed of the system, but it doesn't seem to make any difference. Under Storage, the system is able to manage all of the games that I've installed to my SD card without any problems. And that's about it for settings. What I want to do now is run this in windowed mode just to make it easier to see system utilization. You can see that with just Steam running and nothing else, the CPU cores are putting in a lot of work to render this window. There should be a lot of room left on the table for optimization because this is running far from native speeds, and it's even running far from translated speeds. This feels closer to software rendering performance at this point. So let's now take a look at how the system operates when we try to launch a game. Just be aware that this system is using a lot of processing power just to run this UI, but I don't think it'll have any impact on the games that I've picked. Let's go to Steam World Heist and head into the settings. This is a game that I featured in my last video, and it's very easy to run at full speed. This is a native Linux game, so I haven't had to set anything under the compatibility tab. This game should just launch without any issues. When we launch it, it runs in a window, since that was the last option that I used. The Steam Deck is a bit better in how it handles situations like these, but we can just maximize this window quickly. You might notice that there is no FPS counter, so that doesn't seem to be working at this point. I'd have to enable a different counter just to make sure, but this also seems to be running fine. Let's check out a different game. This is another native Linux game with no big issues. I'm going to turn on the option to run big picture mode in a window because there's another game that is refusing to open up, and I'm hoping that this small change will be enough to get it to launch. Interestingly enough, that does seem to be the solution for this game. This is another easy title to run, but it takes a long time to boot. So far, I have to say this is really awesome to see all of this work at this very early stage. I hope that someone ends up coming in here and is able to package all of this together to make it easier for average users without a background in Linux to get this running so more people can experience this. If it's just a little faster and it can play games from like 10 or 15 years ago on an average Android device or ARM processor, that would be amazing. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I think it's really awesome that we can now run this on an ARM processor, and I can see the day when we have full handhelds that are using something like this. We already have good hardware on ARM, we just need the translation software to get better, so it will be awesome to be able to see something like this in the not too distant future on handhelds and on phones. But that's gonna be it for this video. If you enjoyed this one, don't forget to leave a like. If you have any questions, you can leave those down below. Big shout out to the developer for making this a reality. This is a really cool look at something that I hope will be in a lot of handhelds going forward. Happy gaming, everyone. Taki out.